How to set up a warehouse in Snowflake. Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. In this video, we are going to see how to set up a warehouse using an interface. We are even going to see how to set up a warehouse using SQL Query and how to drop a warehouse. So let's start working on it. In the past video, we have tried to execute a query by extracting the customer table from our database. But when we try to execute it, we are getting an error, and the error is indicating that we have to have a warehouse in order to execute our query. So now the point is, when we do not have a warehouse, we cannot execute or we cannot see any sort of result for the query that we have written. So first we have to create a warehouse. So how to create a warehouse? Let's see first how to create a warehouse using our interface of Snowflake. Let us go to admin, and under admin we have an option called warehouse. So we can see that we do not have any active warehouse. So first we have to create a warehouse. So for this we need to click on a new warehouse plus warehouse here, and we need to give a warehouse name. So let me give a warehouse name. Any warehouse name is your choice. Let me give a warehouse name, and there are two options. One, what type of warehouse you would like to opt. So it is by default the standard that I would like to go with it. And the very important point that we have to consider is the size, and the size of the warehouse that I would like to talk about. There are various sizes that we have it here. So depending upon the usage, we can choose the size. But now coming to the point, the more or the bigger the size we are opting for, so the maximum credits it will use from our particular size. So again, coming to the picture, the more or the maximum number of size that we choose, the more number of credits it will get used from it. So the more number of credit that we are using, the more number of amount that it is going to charge from us when we are using a paid version of Snowflake. So for our particular usage, it is X small, that is enough. But if you are working on a bigger project, if you have a huge data to use it, or if you have a larger data that you are working upon, then yes, you have to use the maximum size or the size that your industry requires and the number of credits it will use for that particular usage. So I am considering X small here, and I am creating a warehouse. So before creating a warehouse, you even have an advanced options here, such as auto resume, auto suspend. So what is this auto resume and auto suspend? If you want to resume your warehouse when any statement that requires, you can do it. If you do not want, you can suspend this warehouse whenever you require. So that kind of options you have it here. And there are even multi-cluster warehouse options, that minimum cluster is one and the maximum cluster is two. Now you might have a question, what is meant by this cluster? So cluster is nothing but it is a dynamic workload. So depending upon the workload that you have, depending upon the usage of the warehouses that you have, so you can set up this one. So maximum I have set up two. You can set up to 10. Okay, it is allowed up to 10. And the minimum it is one. Okay, so if you want, you can, I can make the my maximum cluster as three, and the policy that I have considered, that is standard. Now I am creating a warehouse. So as you can see that a warehouse is successfully created, and the name of the warehouse is compute warehouse, and the size is X small that I have considered. And the interesting thing that we can see, that the owner of this particular warehouse is account admin, which I am. Okay, and it is resumed just now. All right, so I have created my warehouse successfully. So let me walk you through back to my worksheet. And in this worksheet, I have tried to execute a query, and it told me that I cannot create a or I cannot see the result out of it because I do not have any active warehouses. Now I have my warehouse, which is compute.underscore warehouse that I have created. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to select this one. Now the thing is that, let me execute it. We can see that the Snowflake query that I have created, it is getting executed and I am getting the result with the query that I have written. And the point is that this can only be possible when I have my warehouse that I have created. Okay, so we have seen how to create a warehouse, right, using an interface which I have compute warehouse. Now even write an SQL query and create a warehouse. So let me show you how to create that. So for this, we need to create a warehouse, the word keyword warehouse I'm using it. And for this, I would like to choose a new name. I cannot have two similar names for the same warehouse. So I'll use it as the full name, like compute underscore warehouse. And I'm creating this warehouse with is a keyword again, and with warehouse size, if I consider, so warehouse underscore size, which I'm going to use it as x small. And now I have used my warehouse size as x small. So now let me choose my cluster. So maximum cluster that I am going to use is cluster count, which I'm going to use it as 1. Or if, see, I have used my for my previous warehouse that I have considered, I have used my minimum cluster as 1 and the maximum cluster as 3. So let me follow the same here. I am going to use my maximum cluster count as 3, and I could even go and auto resume or auto suspend it. Both the things can be possible. If I want to auto suspend my particular warehouse, I can auto suspend it after my 600 seconds. So 600 that I am indicating here, it is 600 seconds. If you don't want, you can go with 400 seconds or 300 seconds. It purely depends upon you. And I could even go and auto resume it whenever I would like to go and auto resume it. So for that, I'm making the keyword as true, and I'll come down and I'll give a small comment. If you want, you can add it. If you don't want, you can do not add it. Okay, it's purely your choice and it is purely optional. Comment equal to, so what I'm commenting it, that this is my another warehouse. I'm going to comment it as this is my another warehouse. That's it. So now what I'm going to do, I am selecting this and I'm executing it. So warehouse compute underscore warehouse is successfully created. We can see that my warehouse, the new warehouse that I have created using my SQL query, is successfully created. All right. If I come back and if I see under admin, under warehouses, there are two warehouses that I have. This is the warehouse that we have created using the interface, and this is the warehouse that we have created just now using SQL query. So there are two ways of creating a warehouse. One, you can create the warehouse using an interface, and the second way of creating a warehouse is you can create a warehouse using an SQL query. Both the things will work out. So if I come back and if I try to execute a new query, or for example, let me write select star from, so I do again, if I would like to select this one, okay, I would like to execute a query or retrieve some data. So again, I have to come here, select my database name, again there my table name, and so on. So you can avoid this very simply. You can choose it here. So you have a default option. So you can choose it here and you can come here, and then I have my database selected. Now what I'm going to do, just you can type the table name called customer. That's it. So if I execute it using my new database that I have created using my SQL query, that I will execute it, and successfully it's getting executed. So we can see here there are two warehouses that you want, and as you can see, if you would like to do some sort of editing to it, yes, you can do the editing by clicking on here, and you can do the editing here. So to the warehouse that you have existed. So this is where you can create a warehouse using a SQL query. If you want to again drop a warehouse, you can even go very simple way, drop warehouse and warehouse name which you have. If I would like to drop my warehouse that I have created using SQL query, yes, you can do this. I'll execute this one and I'll run it. So compute warehouse is successfully dropped. Okay, so if I come back and if I see in my admin and if I see in my here, so if I refresh it, you can see that we have only one warehouse now which we have created using an interface, but the one which we have created using SQL query, that got successfully dropped, right? So this is how you can create a warehouse using an interface, and this is how we can create a warehouse using SQL query, and this is how we can drop a warehouse using a query. So this way that a warehouse is can be created when we are using Snowflake. And if you want to execute any query, or if you want to see the result out of it, we need to have a warehouse. And how we need to have a warehouse, we have seen just now. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any queries, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.